this lab video, we will look at some simple iterative code to solve ODEs, and we'll also see how we can use MATLAB ODE solvers, which are even compatible with stiff ODE systems, to solve the systems of equations we typically encounter in biochemical networks. Welcome back. Let's look at a MATLAB example. How do we solve ODEs using MATLAB? Let's start with a simple ODE system, something that's very familiar. Dx by dt is A minus Bx. I'm sure most of you can actually integrate this analytically, right? And but how would you implement this in MATLAB? Right. So this is how you would implement it. This is quite straightforward. What do you do? You first set up, you know, a vector for all the values of x, and you, the most important part is somewhere here, where you basically compute what is dx by dt. Dx by dt is A minus Bx, right? That's your function, and x equals x plus f of x into delta t, right? That's what we had here. X is basically x. If you were to look at it from a computational coding standpoint, you would say this is x, is x plus f of x into the current value of x into delta t, right? That's exactly what we are doing here. X equals x plus f of x, which is nothing but dx by dt into delta t, right? That's it. So all the action is happening in line 15 of this code. So let's open this up. Right. So I'm assuming that I'm basically setting a default value of delta t to 0.02, right? And I'm simulating it for 20 units of time. Okay. How do you know the units here? Is it seconds or minutes or hours or days?
By knowing the other
units, yeah, so it will depend upon the units of A, B, and C. It's currently arbitrary units, but you can assume it to be seconds or whatever, right? So, is this program clear to you? You're saying this, all this is just setup, setting up the code, right? So, and T last is important. What is that final time till which I want to simulate? So this is till where I want to plot the graph, right? And what is this? Initial condition, x equals c, right? And then I basically say x all is x, and I'm basically assigning the, well, you know, I'm creating an array with all the values of x, and dx by dt is A minus Bx, x equals x plus f of x into delta t, and end of the time step, and I'm then plotting the value. Let's see how it looks like. Does this look right? What would happen if you analytically solve for it? This is what you get. You get an exponential, right? Some alpha minus beta into e to the minus bt. So it saturates here. What value does it saturate to? A by B.
right? At t equals infinity, this term will vanish, leaving behind a by b, and your a was 20, b is 2, a by b is therefore 10, right? So, x basically goes to a by b. So, for small values of delta t, the numerical solution is accurate. And what is small? You do not know. You have to see what happens. But then, for the solutions can become very unstable if delta t is large. What do I mean by unstable? We look at stability again in the next couple of classes. But what do I mean by unstable here?
If the analytical solution
basically behaves weird, right? So if you change the delta t, see, one thing you can imagine is that lower the delta t, better the accuracy, right? So let's actually do this. Hold on. Dt equals 0. Dt equals dt by 10. Made the delta t even smaller. Let's run the code again. Can hardly see the difference. Can you see the difference? I hope you can see that there are two curves, right? I mean, if you really zoom in, you can see that there are two curves that do not actually overlap, but for practical purposes, they do overlap, okay. So, let us say dt equals. Yeah, no big deal. This is what we would call stable. Your delta t has changed, but your output looks decent.
So, what is the value of b? What is the value of b?
B.
2. As long as it is less than 1, it will be more or less you can extrapolate.
Well, I am not so sure. Gone.
Yes, but you can extrapolate the trend, sir. It is Nyquist theorem.
So,
if the frequency is less than half, at least you can take through.
But here actually the behavior itself has changed, right? Or so it seems, because we are extrapolating, right? So, it is now become discontinuous, and if I make, oops, this is what we mean by unstable. It just misbehaves, right? So, for a change in delta t, the output is unrecognizable. You are getting basically random stuff. It almost like gives you some sort of an oscillation. Let's try.
Maybe 1.5 something.
Yeah. Unstable. So, how do you pick this value of delta t? Right. It is a little tricky, right. See, for a system as simple as this, you do not even need to, you can actually analytically integrate it. You do not have to worry about it, but you want to do numerical integration for systems where it is quite difficult to do an analytical integration. So, there you need to use, there are various ways to pick delta t. You have to kind of find out how the system changes and then try to slowly increment your delta t, and if you are able to get a sort of linear behavior over that domain, it is okay. So, this is the curve, right? So, in 0 to about 1.5, the curve is behaving reasonably well, right? But here there is a rapid, you know, it saturates and so on. So, you can maybe split it into a few linear bits and you might be okay, right? So, if you take a dt of 0.3, it's still reasonable, right? It more or less mimics the original response. Maybe I can superimpose. Okay, it's not too far off.
okay.
But you don't want to be worrying about finding delta t or giving out a value for delta t. So, what would you do? There is a simpler way to do it. We just use a built-in ODE solver from MATLAB. So, here if you see, the code has become even more simple. All these lines have basically been replaced by just t comma x is ODE 23 of dx dt 0 t last x naught. That's it. I still have to give a t last, which is 4 here, and I still have to give a function. What is this? This is your
function.
F of x. And what is this at symbol out here? It's a pointer to a function. So you're pointing. So this is how you give a function as input in MATLAB. So the ODE function, ODE 23s or 23 function itself requires a function as input. Your f of x, basically. So this is a very good reference for you to look up. So do look at this. Of course, there is this book by Ada Klepp and this paper by Mogilner. I will share all those materials with you. I think I have already uploaded it. Okay. So let us understand what is going on here. So this was your original code. This has come down to this, and all the action is happening in this line. So if you see, there are so I have ODE 15s. There are many solvers that you can use. There are a few interesting things here. So let's see, let's check them out. Let's first just run the piece of code. So it's called ODE, right? Is there a problem here? You have to give more t values, right? That seems to be the problem. So let's see. So actually, those values were all correct. It's just that I put the we had joined them through these lines, which was incorrect. These values were correct. So this is something that you need to always worry about when you are modeling an ODE system, right? So your solver. Let's actually zoom in so that you can see it better. So your solver will compute at different points. Right? So you have to tell the solver at which points to compute. So if you see the code, these are the arguments that were passed. What were the arguments? First is the pointer to the function that we want, your f of x function. The last is the initial value, and then these are the points. Right? What does this mean? MATLAB actually handles this quite intelligently in some sense, or problematically in another sense, because there is it assumes a few things. If you give just two numbers, it is assumed as 0 and t infinity. If you give more than two numbers, it will give you exactly at those points like we just had. Okay. So, so let me actually unsuppress the output here and run it. Right. So what do you expect here for t comma x? T should have how many elements? 0, 1, 2, 4. Right. And x again 4. So let's run it. Fair enough.
So what is the value of C?
C is 5. Yeah. What do you expect now? You would expect two values, right?
No, if it is two values, it will work.
But instead, you get how many values? What is this magic number 22? ODE 15 is that right? That's what we use. ODE 15 is chose to take these many steps. And let's actually look at the step size. Initial step size was 0.0179. It kept that for a while, then changed it to 0.0971. I'm sorry. So this was the changing step size. So t values are 0.0179. 0.0179 delta t values, right. So this is the values of delta t. So delta t was 0.0179 for the first three steps, then 0.0971 increased, 0.2038 increased further, 0.2574 increased further, 0.4 increased further, and finally, of course, it stopped at a particular point. It computed it at the last point that you wanted it. You wanted this t last. This is the difference, so if you 4.0. So it ended up computing 3.94, and then you wanted 4.0, so it just took that value. Well, let's actually do this experiment. So now let's make it ODE 15. Oh, there's no ODE 15. So there's ODE 23 is there. So let's look at ODE 23. Yeah, see, this gives you practically you can't indistinguishable quality of output, but only 14 points were used. Let's look at 23S now. It used 2 more points, that's it, 16. The difference between 23 and 23s is 23s is helpful. S functions, the functions, the suffix of x, s are helpful for stiff systems. What is a stiff system? Stiff systems are systems that are essentially difficult to simulate, difficult to solve through ODEs. It's usually because they have multiple time scales. So if you see, there are multiple, there is ODE 15S, there is 23TB, 45, 23, 113, 15I, ODE, I don't think ODE set is a, it just sets some parameters, I presume. But essentially you have so many different functions, they all work in the same way. They take something like t comma x or t comma y is ODE function of add function points initial condition. You can have it in multiple dimensions as well. So this is the standard. T out comma y out is ODE function of ODE function, T span and y naught.
In this lab, we had a brief overview of a simple iterative code to solve ODEs and also MATLAB ODE solvers. In the next video, we'll continue with another lab and look at a paper which describes sustained oscillations in glycolysis, and we'll see how to model a slightly more complex system using MATLAB.